Why you only see in black and white? But you should be living in color. You're walking now, but you were made to fly. Just get the fall. Stop thinking small when you're larger than life. You're amazing, so am I. Let's dress up fancy and drink wine. Let's go crazy, don't be scared. Cause we can conquer the world. Cause we can conquer the world if you.
Thank you all so very much for coming out. My name is Ashley Kirkwood, and I am the host of Passion, Purpose, and Paychecks. We have an amazing panel here today, and the theme of this panel is talking about wearing confidence and what that looks like, and also how that confidence helps you to launch into your passion and your purpose and get paid while doing it, because nobody can work for free for long.
My confidence when starting my business wasn't necessarily at an all-time high. I'm very big on faith, so I had to base my confidence in God, because there's so many things that make you feel afraid about launching out. You're like, I don't know if people are gonna really vibe with this. Is what I'm doing making sense? So I had to just trust that I had everything that God gifted me with for the people that needed me, so that I could kind of step out on faith and actually leave my job.
What would you say to those women and men out there who wanna do it, but don't feel like they have it within themselves to do it?
Confidence isn't really something that you're born with. It's something that you work at day after day after day. We all have similarities, and we can celebrate them. Yeah. But I also think that it's very important for you to celebrate your differences, because that's what makes you unique and different, and that's what people are gonna look at and say, well, yeah, you look like all the other girls, but there's this something about you.
If you don't have a confidence within yourself and you're looking for society to do it, you're gonna be disappointed. You have to have tough skin in any career, in anything that you do, and just be prepared for the naysayers.
Sometimes when you work in an organization that is predominantly white, or where people just do not look like you, whatever that may be, it breaks down your confidence. How were you able to take that experience and allow it to fuel your confidence to start your own business, versus like internalizing the stated and unstated messages that we get as women of color in corporate America?
We are the brand of our business, right? And so even when you're in corporate America, just like if someone asks you, hey, do this PowerPoint presentation, I want this to look a certain way, I'm gonna put my best foot forward to make sure this PowerPoint looks like the best thing you've ever seen, right? But that's me developing my brand in the corporate space, because people get comfortable with the type of work I do. They start recommending me, telling their friends about me. So I think about that in the same context that, you know, I'm this woman who, it may have been the only black person in the room, the only person under 30 in the room, the only African American in the room, but I soaked up what I could in that space and applied it to what I know in life now. And that's what helped me kind of to do even what I do when I help people with branding. I put my best foot forward, and I still make sure that I use what I've learned in those spaces to help the people that I know that may never have experience in those small corporate spaces. Yes.
How do you look fly on a budget? Like, where did you shop, and how did you find things that were able to fit your brand as a business? And how important is fashion in your business?
Before I say any word out of my mouth, people are looking at me, even before I say hello. And so a lot of times, if you are not on point, that'll kind of shut them down from, because I'm doing stand-up. Now I'm more comfortable in my career. Now I have, now I can go shopping without returning it like that. So I've gotten to the point where now I can keep an outfit too, okay?
Models have to be very minimalistic. Hence what you probably see me right now, very black, white, jean, like basic but cute and stylish. That but I've learned how to do that, and how that's actually worked with my budget is because when you work with minimalism, you work with a lot of interchangeable pieces. You know, your basics, a good trouser, a good black trouser, a good blazer, things, interchangeable pieces, where if you've ever seen, you can have 11 pieces in your closet and interchange them all the time and always look like you're wearing something different. And if you like are able to, my big thing was the accessories. Like if you can find yourself, I'm like an accessories, sometimes you could get them for $1 a piece, you know, so I'll go to the beauty supply and get myself some, some, you know, dollar earrings, you know, or whatever. And people were like, oh my God, those are look amazing.
When you have a dream, when you have a goal, it's going to be hard. But the question is, what are you willing to give up?
I was working at least like 55 hours at work. And on top of that was doing the modeling business. And I was taking the money that I was getting from my job to invest in my next career.
I'm doing stuff that was building my business outside of, you know, the 9-to-5 that I had. So I had to sacrifice a lot of the time that I had. You see the cute stuff on Instagram. Mm-hmm. You see people making their money and all this stuff, but you don't see the journey that it took them to get to where they're at. A lot of times we glamorize entrepreneurship, but you really have to truly make sacrifices and be okay with investing in yourself and knowing that whatever vision it is that you want to birth, that it's worth, you know, the sacrifice.
I've given up so much that I'm not willing to, I'm really, really not willing to give up what I stand for, my beliefs.
Yes.
And my beliefs, you know, if you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything.